Hey, what is up, everybody? This is Stevie Breach coming to you here today with an update video that is probably at least a couple months back, is when WWE kind of gave out the news that WWE and WrestleMania land going to Los Angeles probably wasn't going to happen because of the fact that the Los Angeles mayor came out and basically said that Los Angeles wasn't looking to host large events in its city for over a year. And basically, with WrestleMania kind of being in that window, WWE kind of had to think, you know, are we going to be able to slip like a little bribe ski to this guy to be able to let us come in? WrestleMania, you can tell by going to WWE's shop, is easily one of the biggest periods for WWE. Not only do they host WrestleMania, but you get an NXT event. You get two power-packed, SmackDown and Monday Night Raw shows. You have the WrestleMania Superstore that is supported by Access that runs for probably 4 days of just packing fans in and out to meet superstars, get pictures and autographs, get pictures of, like, past relics from WWE's WrestleMania past that you've only been able to see on DVD. But with all the merchandise, all the tickets, all the fans pouring into there, WWE really needs WrestleMania to sort of like be a bookend, like a huge exclamation point on their physical year for the company. And if they're not going to be able to have that in Los Angeles, the former home of SummerSlam, they're going to have to find somewhere else to do it. And as of right now, WWE is looking for another host to basically go to it. As of right now, if you live in the United States, you know that basically the only place there is that is kind of like, hey, do whatever the hell you want to do. Just basically try your best not to get sick, is Florida. I know we've talked about this with SummerSlam being canceled in Boston and then WrestleMania 36 being canceled in Tampa. I think it would be honestly awesome if WWE was able to find a deal for Tampa to host WrestleMania. The one thing is that we're past the point of when like WrestleMania travel packages normally go on sale. Once you get to November, that is kind of the time when, you know, your WrestleMania tickets go on sale, and that's followed by your Raw and SmackDowns, your Hall of Fames, and then your Access tickets. You know, they sort of got to get a plan of where they're going to go so they can hook up with Ticketmaster and sell these things. And then also on top of that, they got to be able to find, you know, the hotel spaces where, you know, these places can not only have their wrestlers, their people that work for the company, the people that are in production, they got to find spots to have all of these people. If they can just basically call the places that they had booked for 36 and say, hey, can we do like a copy and paste for next year for 37, that would be awesome for the company. I'm sure that would also help out a lot of the other companies that kind of piggyback off of WWE, that run their independent shows, that run their WrestleCons. I'm sure that would be awesome for them just to use their contacts that they made for last year's show and just hopefully get in for this year's shows. But basically, you know, you got to worry about booking too big of an arena, a lot like they did for WrestleMania 7 when they thought they were going to have WrestleMania in the Coliseum to have Sergeant Slaughter versus Hulk Hogan, the, you know, Iraq versus United States played out in a wrestling ring with Operation Desert Storm. WWE thought they were going to sell at the Coliseum. They were going to get over 100,000 fans. And at that point, maybe it was because of the steroid trial that was going to be going on, or if it was just wrestling wasn't as big as it was when they did WrestleMania 6 in Toronto. It didn't pan out, and they had to have it in a much smaller sports arena. And they had, I guess, a fifth of the fans that thought they were going to have for that WrestleMania. And it just... that's just where WWF was at the date. Are they going to want to go basketball arena instead of football stadium? Because A, you know, fans aren't going to want to travel, or fans are going to have trouble traveling because of, you know, the way that airline tickets are going right now with less flights as well as less seats available to buy on the flights. Maybe hotels not opening them up or, you know, not having enough spots to have them. So you're going to have less travel to get there. And it's kind of like you're having an in-house or in-city, like, house, not a house show because it's going to be bigger than that. But, you know, that most people are going to be traveling within state, maybe by car, instead of, like, you know, flying in from all over the world like you do with most WrestleManias. There's a lot of things that you're going to have to send out, like email questionnaires and polls. Maybe, you know, just sending out mass emails asking fans, like, hey, you came to WrestleMania 35, you went to WrestleMania 34. Any thoughts on coming to 37? Because you don't want to make demand so strong that you're shutting people out that want to come to your show. And then you also don't want to look bad by having those photos on the internet where people take photos and make it look like an old TNA show where half of the arena is empty and there's nobody there. And then obviously WWE gets that kind of like backlash cancel culture on Twitter, on Facebook and all that jazz that makes them look bad in the long run for not being able to actually sell out the show that they want to have. So WrestleMania 37 is going to happen one way or another. As of right now, it is not canceled, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen in Los Angeles. So they're just going to find out where it's going to go. And as of right now, kind of looks like Florida is going to be the leader. But, you know, they don't even really want to do SummerSlam in the Performance Center because they're getting tired of that. So they got to find out where in Florida that they're going to go. My hopes as of right now, pay back the city of Tampa Bay and see if you can actually do it there in the home of the Bucks.